Philippine mayors meet with agriculture officials to discuss the effects of the prolonged dry spell and food security. The mayors who hailed from different regions also raised on Thursday their concerns on improving high-value crop production and constructing farm-to-market roads. The Agriculture Department assured local officials that their concerns will be addressed. Dozens of areas in the Philippines have been placed under a state of calamity due to El Nino, which has cost billions of pesos in damage to farmlands. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department says Austria is hiring more Filipino skilled workers to meet its labor demand. DMW Secretary Hans Leo Kakdak says Vienna plans to recruit 500 Filipino workers annually as it grapples with a labor shortage in several industries. The two nations signed labor deals last year for the hiring of Filipino nurses and other skilled workers. There are currently 5,000 OFWs working in Austria. Deployment of Filipinos to the European country more than doubled in 2022. Philippine conglomerate Ayala Corporation begins its divestment in Manila Water. It said today it finalized deals to sell its shares and those of its two units in the water concessionaire to Trident Water of Enrique Razon. The shares are equivalent to 14.5 billion pesos. Razon's Trident Water acquired a 25% stake in the company in 2020. The Ayala Group will continue to divest in Manila Water in the next 5 years when its preferred shares are fully paid for. Also in acquisitions, Aboitiz Power closes its purchase of additional stake in coal plant operators Tayag State Power. Total purchase price was at $11 billion or 634 million pesos. Now this brings to 85% Aboitiz Power's equity interest in the company. Finally, Philippine Airlines boosts its fleet management with a deal with Spanish charter firm Wamos Air. The flag carrier is leasing two units of its Airbus A330-200 aircraft to fly passengers from Manila to Sydney and Melbourne. PAL says the move is to ensure operational resilience, among others, ahead of the peak travel period. The agreement takes effect on June 1st. So President Marcos Jr. admits the Philippine tourism sector is facing tough competition from neighboring countries. He spoke Friday in his home province of Ilocos Norte at the inauguration of a tourist rest spot in the town of Pagudpud. Marcos says the Philippines must step up its tourism development efforts, citing booming tourism in South Korea and other Asian neighbors. To attract more tourists to the Philippines, he said, governments should also focus on easing travel between the country's top destinations.
Alam naman natin, Manila Airport is already very congested. So instead of having to go to Manila, to come to Pagudpud, they will have to go all the way to Manila, and then Manila all the way up to Ilocos Norte, for example, as an example. So like in Cebu, that you already have this, you already have that facility, people can travel from abroad directly to Cebu. People can travel, we will make it so that people will travel from abroad directly to Lawag, directly to Bohol, directly to CDO, directly to Tacloban. All of these other places that we want to promote as tourist destinations.
The Philippine Transportation Secretary urges PUV operators and drivers who failed to meet the April 30 franchise consolidation deadline to avail of government's livelihood programs. These include the two programs which provide free skills, training, and assessment, as well as entrepreneurship training. Secretary Jaime Bautista also said unconsolidated drivers and operators may join existing transport cooperatives to continue their livelihood. Government has begun apprehending unconsolidated PUVs as it goes full throttle on its PUV modernization program.